Now let's complete our view set with the detail. Open S1 section in the view map of the navigator. Zoom in to one of the junctions between the slab and the curtain wall. We'll create a detail drawing of this area. Details can be either linked or independent. Independent details have no live connection to the model content, while linked details derive their content from the area defined by the marker. Activate the Detail tool in the toolbox. In the Info box, select the rectangle placement method. Draw a rectangle around the junction area. Once the rectangle is finished, the cursor changes to a little hammer. Click again to place the detail marker. Zoom out if necessary. As soon as the marker is placed, a new D1 detail view is created in the project map. Open the organizer to add the new detail view to the view map. Select the project map on the left side and the view map on the right side of the organizer. Close the Stories, Sections, and Elevations folder in the view map. Select the Details folder in the project map. Modify the scale to 1 to 20. Drag the Details folder to the right side on the Construction Docs folder. And notice that the new Details View Map folder is created. Close the organizer and check out the new view in the view map of the navigator. The detail view doesn't contain architectural elements anymore, but lines and fills. Activate the Suspend Group command from the toolbar, or by clicking on the Edit, Grouping, Suspend Group menu item. Let's modify the contour of the structural concrete fill. Since it's associative, these elements can be updated if the model geometry changes. Select the concrete fill. You can use the Tab key to find the right fill. Click on its bottom right corner. Choose the Move Node option from the pet palette. Move the corner in line with the curtain wall. You can use a guideline to help the editing. The modification of the fill might not show on the screen because other fills derived from the walls are covering it. Let's delete these fills. We have to modify the fill of the beam. Delete the unnecessary lines. Stretch the horizontal lines as shown on the screen. We can add any additional elements using the available 2D tools. Let's add a fill which represents the ceiling. Select the Fill tool in the toolbox. Select the 2D drafting general layer in the info box. Select the gypsum fill. Make sure that the polygonal geometry method is selected in the info box. Draw a 25mm thick fill under the beam level with the polygonal method as shown on the screen. This is a very effective method. However, in case of assembled structures, it's easier to adopt and customize a typical detail. Let's revert to the detail's original content by updating it. Right-click on it in the view map of the navigator and select Rebuild from Source View. Please note that fills coming from the model are restored to their original state. The fill of the ceiling is invisible because other fills generated from the model elements are covering it. Select the gypsum fill. Use the Tab key to find it after placing the cursor to the location of the board. Activate the Display Order, Bring to Front command from the context menu. Now we'll import a detail from a DWG file. DWG content can be placed several ways into the project, by xref or by merge. Let's assume that the typical detail will change and use an xref to attach it to the detail. Select File, External Content, Attach xref. Browse the W2 curtain wall details.dwg file from the CAD details folder, located in the ArchiCAD Training Series 4, Demo Files, CAD Details folder. Use the default settings of the Attach xref dialog. Click Attach to proceed. Zoom out if necessary, and place the attached details on the right side. The DWG-DXF Partial Open dialog box appears. Here you can specify which layers of the DWG file to import. Here we will import all the layers, which is the default status of the dialog box. Click OK to continue. The line work of the imported drawing appears in the detail, which you can customize to match the current situation.